So welcome to my channel once again. This is the part two of the series that I'm actually bringing you, buying land or building in Ghana basically. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe. Please subscribe to my channel, like the video. You don't lose anything by liking the video. You watch the video, just like, give it a thumbs up, that's all. Or you can comment, and it will help my algorithm, you know, it will help the YouTube algorithm for YouTube to also recommend the video to other people. So please, just like the video. Thank you. So as I said in the previous video, I told you how you can make some searches or checks to ascertain or know whether the land that you are buying is genuine or not. So if you are able to do all these things, then the next point is for you to go and meet the owner. If you eventually get to know that the land that you are interested in belongs to that particular person, the next thing that you need to do is go to the person, whether the person will be an individual or a family or a school land, or the land might be for the government, you understand? So any which of these parties that will own that particular land, just approach, and you've already shown interest, so you are going there to make payment basically. But one thing that I'll tell you is sometimes these people or the owners decide to do the document, that's the indenture for you. The indenture, sometimes the indenture and the site plan, they will decide to do for you. Maybe it's a real estate company. Mostly they will tell you they are going to do the document for you. That is not a problem. If they say they will do the document for you, just what you have to do is, we have something called indenture. Indenture is actually the agreement between you, the purchaser, and the vendors. That's the people who are selling the land to you, and you, the client who is buying the land. So if they tell you that they will do the document for you, allow them. But when they do the document for you, definitely you are going to sign, and they are also going to sign with your witnesses and with your like you also with your witnesses, you understand? And when they bring the documents to you for you to sign, especially for you to sign, and let me chip in this, if you go to them and you want to finally buy the land from them, don't pay all the money to them. Don't pay all the money to them. You can pay some parts of the amount to them. So when they are done with the documents, you understand? When they are done with the documents, then you do what? You give them the rest of the money. Yes, so when that happens, after that, they doing the document and sending it to you for you to sign, go through, like read through the document thoroughly to know or to understand what the agreement is. You see, to understand what the agreement is. Let me show you. This is an example of a site plan. This is an example of a site plan. This is how a site plan looks like. And you see, when the land survey, the land surveyor does it for you, or the draftman or whoever does it for you, they will give you copies, more than 4 copies. Yeah, sometimes some people give 8, some people give 6. They will give you all these copies as your site plan. This is how mostly it's presented to you, especially when it is done. These stamps that you are seeing are from the Lands Commission. You know, in Ghana we have 16 regions, and every region has their own Lands Commission. Every region, Greater Accra has their own Lands Commission. Central region, they have their own Lands Commission. The Western region, they have their own Lands Commission. The Volta region, everybody has their own Lands Commission. So the Regional Lands Commission usually does these things. And you see, you are seeing a stamp here, and this is the license surveyor. he will also sign, stamp and sign for you. You understand? On all these things. But you are just going to pay the draftman or the license surveyor for them to do, or the architect to do all these things for you. You understand? So this is a site plan. And this is a land document. That's what we call the indenture. This is how it looks like. Sometimes this paper that you're seeing in my hand is white. Yes, but sometimes it's different colors, but it's the same document. So far as you are seeing these things, you see they have written here the indenture. They've dated it between who, the vendor and the purchaser. Everything is here, you understand? Nowadays, there is a law that was passed. Yeah, recently there was a law that was passed. The government passed, and they are saying you cannot do outright purchasing in Ghana. That law was passed in 2020. So Ghanaians who own land or can buy land and own it for 99 years, and foreigners will also or can also buy land and own it for 50 years. So 99 years for Ghanaians and 50 years for non-Ghanaians. So that's why I said in the indenture, you need to make sure you have a renewal clause in the indenture. That's why I told you, make sure you read through thoroughly to know whether, like, to understand the agreement between you, because it is not, you did not do it, especially if this the person who is selling the land to you says he is going to do it. You need to, like, the moment you get the document, make sure you read through and understand. If there is anything that you don't understand, approach them and ask them about it before you do what you sign. So that is it. When that is done, then when they do the document for you, then you can do what? Pay the rest of the money to the owners and take your document. That's the site plan, signed, stamped, and the indenture, also signed, stamped. Because the indenture too, they are supposed to take it to the High Court for the registrar there to also stamp and sign, and a solicitor also to sign, stamp and sign. So make sure all that is done before you give them the rest of the money. After getting your land documents, the next thing that for me you need to do is to go to the lands commission. In any, I told that, like as I told you earlier, in Ghana we have 16 regions. So depending on where you bought your land, you would have to take your land document to the lands commission for registration. You have to take your document to the lands commission, the regional lands commission for registration. Because when anything happens on this particular land, one thing that mostly the court looks out for is the land registration. So if you have registered the land, then you don't have a problem. You understand? But if you haven't registered the land, then you can have a problem. Especially, let me give you an example. Someone, you perhaps bought your land, let's say in 2019. And another person, you know, in Ghana, we have these things happen. We have people who sell land to three parties, four parties, two people. Like, it happens. You understand? So imagine this same land has been sold to one person already. And you have also bought the land. And perhaps you bought yours in 2019. And the person also bought his in 2020 or even 2021. What happens is that if the person who bought his land in 2021 goes to register the land, and you that bought your land in 2019 have not gone to register the land, I'm telling you, you can have a problem. Or that person who has registered their land can easily take the land away from you. They can easily take the land away from you, because mostly the law courts, what the law court actually looks out for is the registration at the lands commission. So make sure after you buy your land, you go to the lands commission and do your land registration. That is very, very important. Yes, so thank you so much for watching this video too. The next video too, I'm going to tell you the next thing that you are supposed to do after you've taken your document to the lands commission, the next thing that you are supposed to do. I thank you. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I thank you so much. Thank you.